वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर अश्विनी आदमने फ्रॉम तुलसीरामजी रायगढ़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी नागपुर विद ए प्लस एग्रीगेटेड कॉलेज इन दिनपुर. सो टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर सी अबाउट द दैट इज द डेरिवेशन ऑन द थाउजेंड सेकेंड ऑर्डर आयनाइजेशन कोएफिशिएंट दैट इज गामा. सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द प्राइमरी आयनाइजेशन कोएफिशिएंट डेरिवेशन and what are the basic difference between the primary ionization as well as secondary ionization coefficient. Now whenever we have to solve the derivation for the second order ionization coefficient that is gamma, so the first step is, that is step number 1, by considering, that is by considering the primary ionization coefficient equation, and this is, that this one is a, that is I is equals to I zero exponential into alpha d. This is equation number 1. Yes, so whenever in the previous lecture we are just discussing about the, that is a Tausen's derivation for the Tausen's first order ionization coefficient. So at the last of this derivation of the primary ionization coefficient, we are just deriving this condition, that is I is equals to I zero exponential alpha d. So here alpha is the, that is the primary ionization coefficient. Yes, okay. Now, so this is for the primary ionization. Now, whenever here the secondary electrons, that is the secondary electrons emitted due to the interaction of, due to the interaction of positive ions and cathode. Yes, so all of you know that how this secondary electron will be generated in the process of ionization, right? So this secondary electron will be generated by using or by the interaction of the positive ions as well as this cathode. So that's why I just write down here the number of electron, that is n is equals to n 0 plus n plus. Yes, this one is a secondary electron emission, right? Now here n 0 is nothing but the electron emission due to positive ion impact, and n plus will be the electron emission due to the photon impact. So whenever we are just see the unit number 1, so how this electron will be generated due to the positive ion impact, and how this secondary electron will be generated due to the photon impact, this all the part we are just covered in the previous lecture. Okay, so now we are just rewriting our equation number 1 into the term of this secondary electrons. So therefore, first we are just rewriting this equation 1 into the form of number of electron, that is, and this one is equation number 2, and so now that is n is equals to n 0 e to the power alpha d, this one is expression number 3, and now we are just putting the total number of this secondary electron. So this is nothing but, that is the n0 plus n plus e to the power alpha d, and this one is the expression number 4. Yes. Now later, this one is equation number 4. Now the total number of electrons reaching towards the cathode after completion of the primary ionization process is nothing but the capital, or it is nothing but the small n. That means this procedure will be completed here. So after this procedure, we have to do one assumption, and this assumption is nothing but the total number of electron will be reaching at the cathode after completion of the, that is, a primary ionization process will be completed here, and this one is a small n, right? Okay. Now the second step will be condition will be assumed here, and this condition will be the assume the total number of electrons reaching at cathode whenever our primary ionization process will be get completed. And this one is denoted by small n. Yes. So here we have to do one assumption. This assumption is nothing but the total number of electrons reaching at the cathode whenever our primary ionization process will be completed, and this number of electron is nothing but the small n, right? Now the number of secondary electrons reached from cathode is, that is, N0 plus N plus. This one is a secondary number of electrons which will be the reach towards the cathode. It is in the process of secondary ionization, and this is how much? This one is N0 plus N plus. This one is a secondary electrons. Right. So this one is a total number of electrons, and this one is a secondary, that is a number of electrons whenever the secondary electron will be generated. So this is nothing but the secondary electron, that is N0 plus N plus. Now therefore the total number of electrons releasing from the gaseous molecules is equals to N minus N0 plus N plus. Yes, that is the total number of electrons which will be releasing from the gaseous molecule, and this one is this N minus N0 plus N plus. This N is nothing but what? This N is nothing but the total number of the secondary electron reached from the cathode. Sorry, this N is nothing but the total number of electrons reaching from the cathode where the primary ionization will be completed, and this one is the secondary number of electron, right, which will be reached from this cathode. Now assuming here one more condition, therefore each positive ions, that is H positive ions releasing, that is a gamma coefficient here, coefficient
gamma effective coefficient, electron. Yes. So that's why I just write down here the n plus is equals to gamma in bracket n minus n zero plus n plus. Yes. So yes, this one is like this. Now here we are just doing one assumption, and this assumption is nothing but what? He assuming the each positive ion is releasing the gamma coefficient electron. That means this number of electrons whenever you release here, so it is the effective coefficient of this secondary ionization, that is gamma. So that's why we are just here, write down here the gamma is the effective coefficient of this total number of electrons, that is this n minus n zero plus n plus. Now we are just rewriting this, we are just solving this equation. So yes, so I am just write down here this equation, n plus is equals to gamma minus n minus n zero plus n plus. Yes, this bracket will be get close and now. Okay, so now we are just solving this expression. So first we have to just changes the sign of this bracket. That means we are just taking here the n zero minus n plus in bracket, right? N plus here. Now we are just multiplying this gamma into whole bracket. That is gamma n minus gamma n zero plus gamma n plus, and this n plus is as it is. Now we have to connecting this, that is the gamma. Sorry, we have to connecting this n plus term on the one side. That we are just collecting the n plus term on the one side. So that's why I'm just writing here n plus minus gamma n plus is equals to gamma n minus gamma n zero. So here we are just taking the n plus will be get common. So here we are just obtaining 1 minus gamma is equals to gamma n minus gamma n zero. So in the next step we are just obtaining here gamma n minus gamma n zero upon this 1 plus gamma here. Yes, and this one is the expression, that is the expression number 5. So now this expression number 5 we are just putting into this equation number, that is equation number 4. So equation number 4 is n is equals to n0 plus n plus exponential into alpha d. This one is your expression number 4. So whenever we are just putting this value for this n plus into this equation number 4, so this equation number 4 will be rewriting here, and this will be become, that is n is equals to n zero, instead of this n plus we are just write down this whole value gamma n minus gamma n zero upon this 1 plus gamma into e to the power alpha d. This one is this expression. Now we have to solve this expression whole term here. So that's why I just write down here, that is n is equals to this bracket we have to just multiply, that is cross multiplication here, do here, and this one is n0, that is 1 plus gamma plus gamma n minus gamma n0 upon 1 plus gamma, and here that is exponential into alpha d, right? Now again we are just solving here, that is n0, this n0 will be multiplying this bracket, so we are just obtaining n0 plus n0 gamma plus and gamma minus gamma n 0 upon that is 1 plus gamma n 2 this that is exponential alpha t, and this n will be write down here, right? Now this term and this term will be get cancelled, and we are just obtaining here this n is equals to n 0 plus gamma n upon 1 plus gamma into exponential into alpha d. Now we are just shifting this term towards this, that is n 1 plus gamma, and we are just multiplying this whole bracket into this. So we are just obtaining n 0 e to the power alpha d plus gamma n e to the power alpha d, right? Now again we are just multiplying this whole bracket, that is n plus gamma n, right? Now so whenever we are just multiplying this whole term, that is n 0 e to the power this alpha d and this both the term, we are just obtaining here this n 1 plus gamma. Yes, just 1 minute. That is n, that is gamma n is equals to n 0 exponential alpha d plus gamma n into e to the power alpha d. Now we are just collecting the n term on the this side. Yes, so our equation will be rewriting this, that is n plus n gamma minus gamma n into e to the power alpha d is equals to n 0 e to the power alpha d. So our expression will be like this. We are just taking the common, that is n term, so n will be common, so 1 plus gamma minus gamma e to the power alpha d is equals to n 0 e to the power alpha d. And finally we are just obtaining the condition, that is n is equals to n 0 e to the power alpha d upon that is 1 plus gamma minus gamma e to the power alpha d. And this is for the expression for the that is a tau string second order ionization coefficient, that is gamma. Now this expression we have to find out, that is final expression, n is equals to n 0 e to the power alpha d upon 1 plus gamma minus gamma into e to the power alpha d. Now this expression I have just again rewriting it is in the form of current. So whenever I just write down this equation into the current form, so it is just write down here, that is I is equals to I 0 e to the power alpha d upon 1 plus gamma minus gamma into alpha d. So this expression in the form of current, and this one is a derivation for the tau string second order ionization coefficient gamma. So yes, thank you.